Hello everyone, Tom from everystepcalculus.com, everystepphysics.com. Problem with linear approximation in calculus 3 with three variables in this video. Let's do it. Index 8 to get to my menu. You can press second and the cursor here to go down screen by screen to get down to the L section where linear approximation is. Three variables. Here's the formula. W equals linear approximation equals the function of x, y, z. And the change in the function here is almost the same as the derivative of the function. So here's the derivative here. Write this stuff on your paper, of course. Alpha to put anything into these entry lines here, we're going to put the function in alpha. They're all square roots in these linear approximations. X squared plus Y squared plus Z squared is the function. Close off the parentheses. I always show you what you've entered. You can change it if you want. And we're going to put in, you can see the example with on the screen here. And so the alpha 3.02. These are the points where you're going to approximate at. Alpha 1.97. Alpha 5.99. Again, I show you, these are the ABCs of it, the whole numbers of the fractions here. Dx, dy, dz is these x minus a and y minus b and z minus c, which is this right here, minus a. Here's y minus 2 and z minus c. And then we have the derivative of w with respect to x, w with respect to y, w with respect to z. Here's the how that turns out. And at 3, 2, 6 equals 0.429. A partial of y at 3.26 is 0.286. Partial of z at 3.26 is 0.857. And the actual function at 3.26 is 7. So we're going to add these things together. In other words, dx, dy, dz, add it together, and then we times the dx, dy, dz, and dw equals 0.009. And 7 plus this equals 6.991. Pretty neat, huh? Try that by without my program. Try it by memory sometime with all the other nonsense of calculus. Hey, have a good one. Subscribe to me and my site, and you can see other videos that I might make. Have a good one.